Welcome to virtual class, subject science. The concept is motion and measurement and distances. Students, let me ask one question. There is a term used for the movement of animals or objects or human beings from one place to another. Suppose one car moves from Dharwad to Hubli, or we students move from home to school. Teachers also move from school to home and home to school, etc. So all these movements we can call in science as a motion. Motion is the movement of objects or animals with respect to time from one place to another place. And how we call these motion in terms of, let me ask one question. What is the distance from your home to school? What is the distance from the market to your home? What is the distance from place to place? What is the distance from village to the city? So like this, we say in terms of some units. So these are, we call the measurement of distances. Any distance is measured in a measurement call. The small distances in terms of centimeters, millimeters in the scale, in the using in the tapes, etc. And longer distances are measured in meter, kilometers. Longer distance like villages to city, from one city to another city, Bangalore to Delhi, Bangalore to Hubli. So these are measured in kilometer. This scale is used in our study purpose and to measure the smaller objects. What is the length of this board? We can measure by using such a scale. So this side it has the centimeters up to 30 and here 15 inches. So we have to hold from zero, starting from the zero point. And up to this, again we have to mark this and take another distance. So 30 to up to 25. That means this length of this board is 55 centimeters. So like this we can measure from 0 to the respective numbers. So these are how the measurements are used, the centimeter, meter and kilometers are used in the measurement of distances. These are worldwide using units. We call these as SI units, international units. People use worldwide, so we call them as SI unit. What is the SI unit of distance? It is centimeter, meter or kilometer. Okay. So motion is along the distance, along curved line, along circular line. Suppose the distance is straight. For example, from A to B. What is the length from A to B? We can measure easily by using scale or measuring tape very easily. Say this is 15 centimeter. But if the curve is like this, if it is not in straight line, so how to measure such lines which are not straight? They are measurement of curved lines by using threads. So such curved lines can be measured by using threads. First we have to keep the end of the thread towards from the starting point like this. You have to keep the thread along the curved line so that we can get the length of curved line as the length of the thread. So the length of this curved line is this much. Then we have to take the scale, then keep along the scale and to measure it. This is how curved lines are measured. So the length of this curved line is 26 centimeter. So this is how the length of curved lines and straight lines are measured by using the scales. The another method means how to measure the clothes. You can see if you go towards a cloth center, cloth merchants and tailors, what you could see there? So scales are used for measuring length of the objects or breadth of the objects. Here is the tape. Where it is used? It is used by the tailors. This is also measuring tape. One side we can see the inches and the other side we can see the centimeters. It is up to how much? It is 1.5 meter. 150. So these are the units we call measuring units. Then how the measurements are used? Which is the small measurement? Millimeter. 1 millimeter is smallest fraction of 1 centimeter. That is 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So such 100 centimeters together form 1 meter. And 1000 meters together form 1 kilometer. That means 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. You have to remember all these units. So these units are SI unit. We call the SI unit of distances is meter, kilometer. So not only motion, there are the ways of transportation. Transportation is also carrying along with the motion of the objects, carrying goods from one place to another. Not only we people go and meet the neighbors, go and meet the relatives, friends and meetings, any conferences, any important things, any important meetings, but along with that we carry some objects. We call that as transportation. How the transportation is carried? Transportation is by means of three ways. They are through landway, airway and waterway. So what is this landway? Landway is by means of land transport on the land, on the roadways. So which vehicles are used on the roadways? Cars, buses, cycles, even we go by walk on the roads. Trucks, lorries, trains, even big buses and trucks, etc. You know, all these are means of transportation by means of landway on the roads. And airway, above the land, through the air. So air transportation is carried by means of helicopters, aeroplanes, jumbo jets. So this is costlier than the land and water because it needs more fuel, costly fuel such as kerosene, pure kerosene and pure petrol. So airway is costlier and it is fastest means of transportation. We can move quickly more than the land and water. Then waterway, through the water from the rivers, we can cross across the rivers, streams, lakes, ponds and even seas and oceans. What are those transportations on the waterway? They are boats, ships, cargo ships, many machine boats. Nowadays there are improved types of machine boats, machine ships are used in the waterways from one country to another country, from one continent to another continent. Even we can round the earth through the waterways. So submarines and ships are also used in the military wars. So all these are means of transportation. These are the ways: land way, airway and waterway. Now, what are the moving things around us? We can decide, so many things are around us, we can decide them as which substances are at rest and which substances can move. Here only we can see many objects like scale, board, chair, this grill, rods, wall, duster, even this rolling tape, scale, chalk, duster, all these. When we keep these things, they remain there only. We can say these objects are at rest. But some things such as machines, so machines, fans, vehicles, these are sometimes at rest. When we use them, when the machines are on, when the buttons are on, they are movable. Sometimes they are at rest and sometimes they are movable. But the organisms such as animals, insects and human beings are movable because they have moving parts. That is the characteristic feature of living organisms. So like this we can say some things which are at rest and which things are movable around us. We can make list also. Now types of motion. When we say motion, when the car moves from one place to another place, we say this is motion. But motion is what kind of motion? Say from the point A towards the point B. What is this line? This is straight line. So this from this point to A and to reach the point B, it is road is straight. We can say the motion is straight and it is same. We can call it as rectilinear motion. It is rectilinear motion. So what are the examples for the rectilinear motion? So many examples we can give. What kind of motion is? You can see in the sprinters in 100 meter race, so running race. And can you think more such examples in our surrounding? March fast of the soldiers in parade, or falling of the stone. Suppose you throw a stone, that is also along straight, and that pendulum comes back also in a straight line. When the cars move along the roads, we can call this as the rectilinear motion. And what is the motion of ant? Ants move from one place to place. Each point can be marked. So motion seems to be same kind of a change in the position of the object with the time. And sewing machine, objects like clock, all these are having different types of movements. So let us know how some types of motion help us and understanding these distances. Some examples of rectilinear examples we can give: march fast during the parade and movement of objects around a fixed point. Here is ox moving around a fixed point. In this motion, the distance of the stone from a fixed point, it remains the same always. Okay, this is rectilinear. When the distance from a movement, distance from a fixed point, suppose you say like this, or movement of leaves of the fan, all these can be classified as circular motion. Movement of fans and this cock, wind cock, all these are, you can say, the circular motion. Second one is circular motion. Circular motion is the second type. The electric fan or clock by themselves are not moving from one place to another, but the blades of the fan rotate, and so the hands of a clock. The blades of the fan rotate when we put on the electric switch. So if we mark a point anywhere on the blade of the fan, on the other hand of the clock also, the distance of this point from the center of a fan of the clock or fan, that will remain same. Suppose this is a fan and this is, when they rotate, the distance is same. So such type of rotation is called as, movement is called as circular motion. Another type, for example, in clocks, pendulum of the clock, it moves from one point to another point like this. And in the bells also, church bells, in the temple also, when we go and ring the bell also hangs from one point to another. It we call to and fro. So this kind of movement is called as from to and fro. It is called periodic motion. In swing also, we can give the example of swing. The children play in the garden, they play in swings. We call it as a movement of swing from one place to another is remaining same from one point to is another point. It is periodic motion. Third type of motion is periodic motion. Can notice the differences in these type of motions. Now, did you observe a sewing machine as a part of activity? You must have observed this means the same location while its wheel moves with a circular motion.
It also has a needle that moves up and down continuously. As long as the wheel rotates, isn't it? This needle is undergoing a periodic motion. Have you observed closely the motion of a ball along the ground? So here the ball is rolling on the ground, rotating as well as moving around the ground. So thus the ball undergoes rectilinear motion as well as rotational movement. So can you think of other examples where objects undergo combinations of different types of motion? Did the measurements activities and discuss some kinds of motion? We saw the motions are changing in the position. So these are the examples where the positions are changed with respect to time. The change in this position can be determined through distance measurements. So this allows us to know how fast or slow the motion is. And we can also, the speed can also be measured slow or faster. The movement of a snail on the ground, a butterfly flitting the flower from flower to flower. So the butterflies, the wings of the butterflies flit from flower when they move from flower to flower. A river flowing, an aeroplane flying, and also moon going around the earth, blood flowing inside the body show the motions everywhere around us. So these we can call as many types of motions. The types of motions are rectilinear motions, which is along the straight line, and circular motion is in a circular way. For example, we can give moon also rounds around the earth, and movement of earth around the sun we call as revolution, and also it moves along the axis like this. When you throw a ball around the ground, the movement of ball is not only on the same, that is rectilinear, but also it revolves around its axis, that we call circular. It is combination of both rectilinear and circular motion. And another time, periodic motion. The movement of object is within the same. It moves from and to and fro, from a fixed point, from and to. To and fro. So this type of periodic motion we can see in pendulum of the clock. You can give many more examples which you can see around you for all these kinds of motions. So this is about motion and measurement of distances chapter in the science. Let me summarize the lesson once again. Different mode of transport are used to go from one place to another, and the ancient times the people were using, in olden days people were, what they were using? They were not using the cars and trains as now we are using different kinds of vehicles, but they were using by means of carts, tangas, horse carts. Even they were using animals like donkeys, yaks on the mountain, so etc. Animals are used for their transportation, for carrying their goods also, as well as for their traveling. So this caused a confusion and need to develop a uniform system of measurement arose. Now we use international system of unit, that is SI unit. This is accepted all over the world. The meter is the unit of length in SI unit. Motion in a straight line is called rectilinear motion. In a circular motion, the object moves such that its distance from a fixed point remains the same. Motion that repeats after some period of time is called periodic time. So, motion that repeats itself after some period
motion which repeats after some time of period is known as periodic time. And you can give so many examples which you can see around you. So this completes your lesson, motion and measurement of distances. Thank you. Have a nice time.